In this video, we are going to be looking at calculation of comparative cost advantage. Comparative cost advantage was developed by David Ricardo in 17th century in respect to the shortcomings of absolute cost advantage. Comparative cost advantage implies that the country should specialize in production of products which it has relative lower opportunity cost to a trading partner. So it means that there are two countries and there are two products. So for a country to concentrate on a particular product, she must have a comparative cost advantage over a trading partner. So let's quickly look at this table to understand what you are talking about. We are having Nigeria and Germany in the world by assumption, and they are producing cotton and cocoa. Nigeria here is producing 100 meters of cotton and also producing 300 tons of cocoa based on the resources she has. And again, Germany is producing 50 meters of cotton and 100 tons of cocoa based on the resources she has. So the total, the world output becomes 150 meters of cotton and 400 tons of cocoa. When you had 100 plus 50, then you have 150, you have 300 plus 100, you have 400 here. Now let's now look at what happened after the introduction of comparative cost advantage. Now let's check comparative cost advantage of cotton to cocoa in Nigeria. That is, how much is Nigeria for going to produce cotton, 1 meter of cotton. For Nigeria to produce 1 meter of cotton, how much is for going? That is, how many tons of cocoa she's going to forgo. But to understand this concept very well, we need to introduce a ratio. That is why we introduce ratio here. You introduce ratio. Now let's check ratio of cotton to cocoa in Nigeria. You know Nigeria is producing cotton and is producing 100 meters of cotton and 300 tons of cocoa. Because we are looking at cotton first, that's what you are looking at. The product you are looking at will come first. So we say 100 over 300. So when you say 100 over 300, you'll be having, 1 over 3. So it means that when you convert it to ratio, 1 over 3, convert 1 over 3 to ratio, you'll be having 1 ratio 3. It means, yes, that Nigeria is forgoing 3 tons of cocoa to produce 1 meter of cotton. 3 tons of cocoa to produce 1 meter of cotton. So when you go to Germany, we are checking how much Germany is for going to produce tons of cotton. So we are taking 50 first. That is, we are taking cotton first. We're going to be having 50 over 100. So when you have 50 over 100, that's going to be give you 1 over 2. And by taking it to ratio, you are going to be having 1 ratio 2. So it means that Nigeria is for going 2 tons of cocoa to produce 1 meter of cotton. Now, when you check the opportunity cost, Nigeria is forgoing, opportunity cost here is 3 tons of cocoa, while opportunity cost here is 2 tons of cocoa, in production of cotton. Then you can see that Germany has lesser opportunity cost compared to what Nigeria is forgoing. And as such, Germany has comparative cost advantage over Nigeria. Then Germany is going to be producing cotton for herself and for Nigeria. Let's quickly look at a country now that is going to be producing cocoa. Because we are checking cocoa first now, so we take ratio of cocoa to cotton, and in that case now cocoa will come first. We're going to be having 300 over 100, 300 of cocoa over 100 of meter of cotton in Nigeria. So we are going to be having 3 over 1. When we have 3 over 1, taking to ratio, we are going to be having 3 ratio 1. That is what we have here, 3 ratio 1. It means that Nigeria is forgoing 1 meter of cotton to produce 3 tons of cocoa. But we don't need 3 meters of cocoa. That is not what we 3 tons of cocoa here. What we need is, we want to check how much Nigeria is going to produce just 1 tons of cocoa. So when you have a question like this, what you do now is you take reciprocal to know how much, because what we have here is Nigeria is going 1 meters of cotton to produce 3 tons. We are not talking about 3 tons now. We want to see how many Nigeria is for going to produce just 1 ton of cocoa. So to get that answer, now you take reciprocal of your answer. Since we have 3 over 1, reciprocal of 3 over 1 will be 1 over 3. Just transpose it, 1 over 3. So when you punch your calculator, 1 over 3 will give you 0.33. It means that Nigeria is for going 0.33 meters of cotton to produce 1 ton of cocoa. Now let's go to Germany. Germany, let's see how much Germany is for going to produce cocoa. So to produce 1 ton of cocoa. So because we are checking Germany, we are checking cocoa first. Cocoa will be first, which is numerator. That will be 100 over 50. That is going to be 2 over 1. When you take it to ratio, you're going to be having 2 ratio 1. When you have 2 ratio 1, you can see it's not what we really want. We are having 2 tons of cocoa yet, and we are forgoing 1 meters of cotton, but we need 1 ton of cocoa. We want to see how much Nigeria is forgoing just to produce 1 ton, and our answer is not giving us that. So what you do again, you know, when you have question like this, just to take reciprocal, you know, this one here give a direct answer, but here we are having another thing. So what you do now is take reciprocal of 2/1. Now you take reciprocal of 2/1, you're going to be having 1/2, that is 0.5. It means that Nigeria is forgoing Nigeria is forgoing 0.5 meters of cotton to produce 1 ton of cocoa. So when you check it now, we check the opportunity cost now, you see that Nigeria has a lesser opportunity cost to that of Germany. Nigeria is producing is forgoing 0.33, while Germany is forgoing 0.55. It means that Nigeria has Nigeria has a comparative cost advantage over Germany in production of cocoa. So that Nigeria will produce cocoa for herself and for Germany. Now, that is the what is comparative cost advantage is all about. But one of the beauty of comparative cost advantage is that the total output will increase. So initially, you can say that our total output will be when we have 150 meters of cotton and 400 tons of cocoa. When you add it together, we are going to be having 550 outputs. But let's look at what really happened when we introduce our comparative cost advantage. Look at this point now. Nigeria's total output here. Already Nigeria is producing 300, Nigeria can produce 300 tons of cocoa. But instead of using that resources, which she uses to produce cotton, she's now using it to produce cocoa, because she's concentrating she's concentrating on cocoa production, and that is what we are having now. Instead of producing cotton now, she's using that resources of producing 100 meters of cotton, she's using to produce cocoa now. So it's going to be that 100 over the opportunity cost, which is 0.33, we should have here 0.33. So it's going to be 100 divided by 0.33, it's going to be 300 tons. It means Nigeria will use, you know, the resources she's using to produce 100 meters of cotton to produce another 300 tons of cocoa by concentrating on and production of cocoa. So she's not producing cotton again. So it's having total of 600 tons of cocoa now. 600 tons of cocoa. Now let's go to Germany. Germany already is producing 50 meters of cotton. Now she's now using the resources to have used to produce 100 tons of cocoa to produce cotton again, because she's concentrating on cotton now. So we are going to be having the already 50 meters of cotton plus 100 over 0.5, that is the opportunity cost here. 0.5, that is going to be 100 divided by 0.5, give us 200. So what she was supposed to have used to produce 100 tons of cocoa, she's now using to produce 200 meters of cotton. So when you add it together, it's going to give you 250. There's a mistake here, sorry about that. It's going to be 250 meters of cotton. So when you have 600 plus 250 meters of cotton, we are going to be having 850 total output here, not 900. That's a mistake here. So it's going to be 850 total output. When you compare 850 total output to 450 total output, you see that the world output has increased. Even when you take it one after the other, check the 600 tons of cocoa here instead of 400 tons of cocoa. Then check the 250 here, the 250 here of cotton to 150 meters of cotton. You can see that when you introduce comparative cost advantage, you know, theoretically there is going to be increase in total output. Although there are some criticisms of this comparative cost advantage, which we are going to be discussing, God willing, in our next video. Please don't forget to subscribe. When you subscribe, you see more of our lovely video, you know, with stunning explanation that they are nothing but unprecedented. Thank you.